Soon as I enter, you know who it is. This the representative from the east side of Atlanta. That's no.
Hi, I'm Crystal Streets at Mercedes-Benz Fashion Week.
Hey, what's up? I'm Adrienne Bailon.
Hi, this is Robert Purdy.
This is Anika Noni Rose.
What's up? This is Aubrey O'Day.
Lance Briggs.
Hi, I'm Cataluna.
Hi, I'm Cynthia Bailey from The Real Housewives of Atlanta.
Hi, this is David Bounty.
This is Jennifer Williams from VH1's Basketball Wives.
This is Nice, and I'm Hom from Gene Tricks, and you're watching DopeFiles.com.
Hey, everybody. This is Jade. You're watching DopeFiles.com. Is that it? Dope Files?
Hey, guys. It's your girl, Janisa Bermudez, and you're watching DopeFiles.com. It's so dope.
What's up? It's Coco and Breezy, and you're watching DopeFiles.com.
It is that time of year again, New York Mercedes-Benz Fashion Week, and we are at Lincoln Center. It's Latasha from Dope Files. You guys are tuned in for all the backstage, the red carpets, the celebs, the socialites, everyone, all the designers. We're bringing it all to you, so stay tuned.
Yeah, I also wanted to inspire other people to do it. And the people that buy my clothes too, I want to inspire them.
Yeah, you know, like you see all the details, like, you know, the colors, like different like layers of colors, and become like cape, some of the cape form, and like sleeve details, and some of the embroidery, you see like, you know, like dragons, fire, you know, clouds, and all mixed together, layers together. I adapted into like more like this, like, I call it like that rich subtle opulence. I grew up with opera, and I see an opera, I mean, that's something that I would love to do, that, you know, transform, you know, those forms and like textures and the colors into a modern day of life.
One of the style pioneers. How you doing, Robert Verdi?
I didn't know I was a pioneer. Oh my God, that makes me feel so old, but I like it. It's okay.
I gave that to you. It's a compliment.
And I appreciate it. I take it. I feel that love. Thank you.
No problem. What shows are you heading to see this season?
You know what I get really excited about? You know, the older you get, the more exciting the emerging talent becomes. So I'm really excited. Tonight is Pamela Love's show, which I'm really excited to see. I just went to see Mandy Coon, who I love. And Patmos, I'm looking forward to. Vibhu Mohapatra, who used to be a designer for Jay Mendel, who's actually showing this season here in the tents. I'm excited to see his collection. So I like to see the emerging talents, because they're sort of the bubbling up ideas and where people are taking greater risks and making unique things happen. You know, they're just not running businesses.
Right. And have you seen anything that really stood out to you? Any outfits in the runways that like were really special to you?
I thought Mandy Kuhn's use of leather was really interesting. She really had the entire collection had a very tough exterior, but there was like an interesting feminine softness, and I just liked her use of black leather because I think that it's a hard material to work with. I think it's hard to make the clothes feel fresh and new because we all sort of see, you know, a black leather pair of pants. We have an idea of what black leather should be. It's a jacket, it's a pair of pants, and I thought she did some really interesting things. So far, I would say that's one of
the... She took leather to the next level.
She took leather to her own level, yeah, yeah.
That sounds fancy. I like that.
Fancy.
Let's talk about your style. Who are you wearing?
I'm wearing, those are actually Florsheim shoes that Ducky Brown designed, which is kind of cool. These are Vintage Revolution jeans. This is a Dolce jacket. I have a Brooks Brothers shirt on underneath. I just got back from India and I bought this fabulous scarf there. And it's an old, this is my high school bag because I was fancy in high school.
Babe, I'm going to put my pinky up on that one.
Right? I was fancy. And it's my bag from high school and I still have it. And I'm really out of high school a lot of years.
Have you seen anybody walking around so that you were like, oh my God, that's awful?
Yes, most people. But the ones that I think are the most awful are the ones that I admire the most, because I think that fashion is about self-expression and taking a risk and doing something original and saying something interesting with your fashion voice. And, you know, whether or not I think it's like tasteful or cool or chic isn't really what it's about. It's really like, are you willing to actually put yourself out there and be original?
We can respect the originals.
I respect the originals.
Thank you so much, Robert. I hope you enjoy your fashion week.
I will, you too.
Thank you.
Well, it's one for the money, two for the show, three to get ready. Now go, cat, go, but don't you step on my blue suede shoe. Well, you can do anything but take me over my...
I am with the designer Heidi Niu for his fall 2011 New York Fashion Week presentation. How are you doing today?
I'm doing good. I'm good.
You look pretty calm for a Fashion Week designer. You should be like running around, pulling your hair out, getting the models.
Yeah, no, I was. I think I have a lot of good people like helping me out, so makes my job a lot easier.
Nice, cool, calm, and collected. You got a strong team behind you. But tell us about your collection this season.
Our collection, the theme is Teddyism, and so it has a lot to do with the 1950s Teddy Boys and Teddy Girls, and we drew some inspiration from a photography series called The Teddy Girl from Ken Russell, and you know, that just kind of shows like the period. It's like a subculture where like the British young people in the UK, they kind of dressed against the norms. And at that time, like Savile Row was like really pushing like Edwardian style.
Tell us about some of the trends that you're really using for this season.
We're using a lot of color blocking for men's fabric combos. Basically, we did sweaters with... you know, like wool sweaters with angora sleeves, like more drapey stuff. Nothing too feminine, but nothing too like masculine for the women.
Who do you imagine wearing Heidi Niu?
People who like, you know, like don't have your typical like, you know, 9-to-5 job. You know, kind of like freelancers or, you know, like architects who could dress a little more casual to work. That's kind of
the cool kid.
Yeah, kind of. I'm accepting of every and all customers, so.
We are running into some more fly celebs here at Lincoln Center for New York Fashion Week. How you doing, Crystal?
I'm great. I'm happy to be here. This is a special, special fashion week for me.
Why is it so special?
Because I'm launching my line, Lyra Love Star. This is an exclusive launch for Lyra Love Star, and I'm so excited. It's my first jewelry collection, and I'm just like elated. I am showing in the accessories exhibit, and the line is featured with like 10 other designers, but it's been amazing. The line is very celestial. It's very reminiscent of like a night sky, and it's very inspirational. Some of the messages are like, reach for the stars, follow your dreams. So I wanted to give that message to young women who are, you know, pursuing their dreams and have passion and determination.
Do you have a favorite piece out of your own jewelry line that you really want everybody to put all their eyes on?
This Octavia charm bracelet.
You're gonna have to give me one of those, Crystal.
Of course, for my friends, of course.
Tell me what you're wearing, because you are a major stylist, so I gotta know what you got on.
You know what, it's crazy, because today I was like, oh, I'm gonna like, I was putting my look together, and I started off with my boots first, because I'm going to tell you why. I've been in heels for 4 days, day and night, 24 hours.
Maybe you're going to need that Dr. Scholl's or something in there.
So I had to do something like, you know, more comfortable, more casual. But my dress and my shoes are by Dolce Vita. My fur vest is Topshop. And I always mix my labels. So everybody thinks I'm this label whore who has to be in like, you know, YSL or Gucci. No, like I'm all about mixing my labels.
What else can we expect from you for 2011?
Well, I have so much going on. You probably definitely see me again on TV. Not sure of what format yet or what network. And I'm just building my brand. It's more from Crystal Street's brand and more from Lyra Love Star. I'm working on my next collection for next year. And, you know, just more of that. Of course, styling too. I can't forget that. That's where I came from.
That's where we need you at.
Yes, definitely. Styling too.
Thank you so much. Have an amazing fashion week here in New York.
Happy fashion week.
This is Latasha with DopeFiles.com, and I'm with Lou, the designer of Dominic Lewis. How are you?
You know, I can't complain about much. It's been a really incredible day.
How busy were you this morning trying to prepare for this huge presentation?
I didn't know what real pressure felt like until you try it for the first time. I think we learned a lot. I have an incredible team that really took a lot of the pressure off. And they've been there for me, and I, again, couldn't have asked for anything more.
Is this your first Fashion Week presentation?
It is. We're in our third season at Dominic Lewis, and this is our first full-blown presentation.
The presentation's amazing. Everything's very dark, very heavy. Like, tell us your inspiration behind this one.
For me, this fall was about this sort of barbaric figure, not necessarily a physical man. It was more about a feeling of that barbarian, and I wanted to channel turning that into something positive. And that's, for me, where the luxury came from, turning all of those sort of intense feelings into a positive inner self experience. And I think we've done that here today.
So you're only in your third season of designing clothes. How did you feel when you knew that you were going to do Fashion Week for the first time?
You know, I've wanted to do it my entire life. And I wanted it to be perfect. So we held off for the first two seasons. And this season, it seemed right.
What do you have for advice for new designers who want to be in your position one day?
You have to do you. You gotta be you at all times, and that's what art is about, and that's what being a designer is about. And with the mass markets growing and growing and growing, you have to push back and realize that it is going to take time, but you can never, never, never give up.
Thank you so much, Lou.
Thank you.
Enjoy your evening.